What are some things that you are grateful for? Literally take a second right now and think about three things that you're grateful for. And that's things that you manifested. Those are things that you attracted into your life. You've done it before and you could do it again. But it starts with reminding yourself of all of the great things that you have in your life so that you can get a feeling for the emotion you feel when you think about what you have obtained. You're already doing this practice. You have to just continue to repeat that emotion of that of which you're grateful for. And if there's something that you have not attracted into your life yet, think about the emotion you would feel once you do receive it. And feel that emotion right now. So take some time and think about what you want. Now, think that you already have it and what emotions you're feeling now that you have received what you want. Take note of those emotions. Now, repeat and repeat and repeat until your subconscious mind thinks that you already have it. And then the subconscious mind will set out the right vibrations into the field that will attract what you want. But you cannot think that you don't have it yet. Because the subconscious mind is going to say, I want this, I don't have it. I'm not going to send out the vibrations to bring that in. So, the emotions matter. What are you feeling once you have received what you have asked for? Continue to repeat and practice those emotions. The world in which you have what you want exists out there, but you can't see it. You just got to get on the right frequency. Like I said in the previous video, you're a magnet, and you have to attract what you want. It's out there in existence. One moment, please. Can you hear that? It's a buzzing noise that continues to go off in here. Just give me 1 second. It's the thermostat. The thermostat that I have in this room is buzzing for some reason. I've never heard a thermostat buzz, have you? No. But I manifested that buzz somehow. Because I think, okay, make it quiet in here, no sound. We can't have sound, we can't have sound, we can't have sound. That's a negative thought. Your mind cannot decipher between positive and negative thoughts. All it knows is it's going to bring you what you think of. So I think of, I think of no sound. No sound, no sound, no, don't sound, don't, no, 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 no sound. Sound comes in. How can I make that adjustment? Is, think about quiet. Think about proper acoustics. Think about the best acoustics I can possibly get with what I have available to me. I'm not exactly sure when I got so spiritual. I think I was born with it. What's up, brother? What's up, brother? When did you get spiritual? Since birth? That's a sketch reference for anybody out there that knows sketch. If not, I apologize. My grandfather was a very spiritual man. He went to church every Sunday, and every Monday when I talked to him, he would ask me if I went to, did you go to church Sunday? And he knew the answer. He knew the answer. Most of the time, unfortunately, the answer was no. But he knew the answer, but he wanted to ask me just to make sure that I knew that he knew. My father's a very spiritual man. If you ever see him in the streets and pick his brain, he reads the Bible daily, and he's got a great perspective. And so I think I was born with this. And over the years, I kind of had a wild streak in my life during high school and college where I didn't care about anything. And then I matured and I got humbled and I realized that it's not just about me, and that if I want to be the man that I want to be, I have to go a step deeper and lean into what I cannot see. And it just grows and it grows and it grows. And I spend a lot of time researching religions and philosophies, and I want the answers. I want the answers. It's a tough life going through the world without knowing what we're doing. You know, don't you want to know what we're doing? And what our purpose is here? You know, because once you understand that, that'll make the rest of your decisions. You know, I'm searching for an answer. I've been searching for an answer for a long time. If you follow the G-Money podcast, I've been searching. I don't even really know what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the first principle. Once I understand what the first principle is, every decision from there on out is easier and is already made. And what I mean by first principle is that which cannot be deducted from. So, like, if we just figure out what we're doing here, that's pretty much all we need to know, and it'll dictate all of our decisions moving on from there. The thing is, I'm never going to know. I'm never going to know. And right when I think I have it, it's gone. You know, and maybe that's the purpose of life, is to forever be right next to the answer. The answers that I'm looking for are right here in front of me, within reach, but they cannot be grasped. They cannot be understood. Whoever made us made us just 1 centimeter away from knowing the answer. And I think they did that on purpose. Because once you knew the answer, you are then the all-knowing. And there's only one all-knowing. And that is God. Or whatever you think God is. There's a source from which we're all made. Whatever the source is. The source made us for a reason, and I am trying to figure out who the source is and why it made us. So Do you have the answers? Because I don't. If you do, let me know. But in this game that is life, I believe there is some answers. Okay, going back to the material things, the things that you can see. There is answers, and they are just asking you. They just want you to ask for them. What you seek is seeking you. But you have to let out the right frequency to obtain that of which you are seeking. Because if you vibrate at a low, low level here, what you want is up here. You gotta just rise to the occasion. And that takes a lot of quiet moments and thoughts and awareness and affirmations and positive thinking. And I'm serious. I'm dead serious. Okay, this isn't just woo-woo, all right? I'm really out here trying to maximize the matrix. Okay, there's a secret code within the layers that the source created for us to find and to withhold and to use to gain what we want. Does anybody have any idea what I'm talking about? I think you do. I think you do. I don't know exactly how to best explain it to you, but you're picking up what I'm putting down. But practice at it and make it your own. I just hope that I've given you some principles and a framework to refer back to, but certainly make it your own and explore. What is this that I'm talking about? Like, I guess you can call it the law of attraction. But it's a personal exploration. It's a personal game. And that you cannot name. That's from within. It's an individual to you. But if you got any idea what I'm talking about, and if you don't really want to, like, leave a comment because you don't want to be put on blast like that, that's fine. I understand that. I'm already on blast right now just by talking about this stuff. And, you know, anyway, you could DM me. And the community, I think a community would help. You know, I think the more power we put into this together, the more power we will have. So, wow. I think that's it. We'll go out the way we came in. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people from all of the world, this is the G-Money Podcast. We are manifesting what we want. I am putting my thoughts and ideas out there for the people. But I do this for you. I don't do this for me. Yeah, I mean, honestly, you know, part of it is for me. Part of it is for me so that I could, because once you start teaching things, then you understand them better. So I guess a little bit of this is selfish, but, you know, I would love to see you be able to harness these skills for yourself as well. Well, we all want to win here and we all can win here. Speaking of winning, this is Win by J-Rock. And I believe Kendrick Lamar is in here too. Pretty sure he's featured in here too. Have a great week. Don't let the Iran and Israel situation lower your frequency. Are we Team Drake? Are we Team J. Cole? Are we Team Kendrick Lamar? Are we Team Scottie Scheffler? Or we Team Max Homa? You know, there's a lot going on there. And hopefully the sun will come out soon. Actually, let's manifest some good weather here. Just think about waking up. One of my favorite things, waking up hearing the birds chirping. All right, if the birds are around, things are moving in the right direction for us. Okay. Birds are manifest. It's already here. The birds are chirping. You see the sun coming through your blinds. You're waking up. You're ready to go to work. Okay. Wow. Guess what? The jacket could stay on the hanger in the closet because we don't need it today. We're going outside with the t-shirt on. Guess what? We don't got to start the car today because it is 80 degrees out. And the sun is going to be shining. And guess what? The beautiful people at the weather station, they said 80 and sunny all day long today. Guess what? You're so white, you might even get a tan today. Thank you. We're blessed to have beautiful weather here in upstate New York or wherever you are in the world. Like if you're in Florida, tomorrow is going to be just beautiful. Tomorrow's going to be beautiful for you. Yeah. No, today's beautiful. Today is beautiful. I think I'm done rambling now. Over and out. Thank you.